Ben Studios dropped a new Days Gone update that comes with a lot of new quality of life additions, fixes, and we now know what all the character skins are that we can unlock in the challenges, with some cool surprises here and there. Oh, and they also added Uncharted 4 inspired content. Everything you need to know about updates 1.30 in this video. Would be awesome if you could leave a like on the video as it shows your support, and let's go. Every Friday we get a new challenge in Days Gone. I already did a video on the most recent new Horde challenge and how you can get a gold score, and that will help you get to rank 5 so you can buy the new character skins that were added with this update 1.30. We can unlock a Sarah character skin so you can run around as Sarah. Pretty cool. And I want to thank Casual Player on YouTube for letting me use his footage. A link to his channel is in the description. Totally check it out if you are German. He unlocked the Sarah skin already that looks really, really cool in game, with a moving ponytail and all, one that I will totally be unlocking as soon as possible. And we also see the hair move for the second new playable character skin from Addie. And I really like how her weapons are positioned on her back, like pretty awesome, with the crossbow placed horizontally instead of facing down, something that we see also with Carlos, for example. Of course, the Ripper boss that you can now play as well, he is the third new character skin with scars and all. No moving hair for this one, obviously. And I never expected this one, but Taylor is now also a playable character. He's of course the drug skit with his trashy clothes and all. Not someone I would get as soon as possible. I prefer the new ladies, I think, but it's still funny that they added him. So for these characters you need to be rank 5 in the challenge modes to unlock them. But we can actually already see the rank 6 characters in the menu too, that you can unlock again when you reach rank 6 in the challenge menu. We got flashback Deacon. So Deacon in his outfit before everything went to shit, like in those cutscenes where he is talking a lot to Sarah. Colonel Garrett is now playable too if you reached rank 6 and got the required credits. And we got Alkai as well from the Hot Springs camp. Very awesome to see that. I'm curious if the game will suddenly feel like Red Dead Redemption 2 if you play as Alkai in one of these challenges. And we also got, last but not least, Shirtless Deacon. It's Deacon, but shirtless, as the description notes. We of course saw Deacon without a shirt multiple times in a cutscene. We'll totally be unlocking all the character skins and showcase them in a future video, but if you already unlocked some, then totally reach out and let me know in the comments under this video, or my Twitter at YourRaptor, Instagram YourRaptor, or the input@YourRaptor.com email address. If you can then shoot some footage, then I would love to include it in a future video. And of course, share the credits. Again, I will be unlocking them myself, but maybe you already got some of the new ones. Let me know. We sadly cannot use these character skins in the main game, but with this update, they did add some bike skins that we can use in the main story, and they are all inspired by Uncharted 4. We got Sam's bike, so the red skin that was used in the famous bike chase. You see a pretty big logo here in the Uncharted 4 cutscene. The logo is a little bit smaller in Days Gone, but it's still pretty similar to the one we saw in Uncharted 4. Really cool to see it in Days Gone like this. The Shoreline bike was also added, the second bike skin. This is a gray one with the red, black, white logo. And we got the bike from the Nate and Sam flashback. So when they were kids, like the bike that Sam bought with his hard-earned cash. In Days Gone, this bike looks very similar, really cool to see. So I would totally say go rock them by going to the mechanic in your game and then go all the way to the right at the decals, and then you will find these Uncharted 4 skins there for free. And update 1.30 also brings a ton of accessibility options. For example, the fact that you now only need to hold a button during the QuickTime events, when being grabbed or when you trigger a trap, for example. So you don't have to like hit the same button over and over again. And I really like this in the Naughty Dog games that added it as well. So it's cool to see it in Days Gone too, because I like holding a button way more than hitting the same one over and over again. You can make the button icons also larger during these sort of QuickTime events, and remove the swipe controls if you don't want them. In the patch notes, they note that they improved the camera flow tracking in the gameplay, so now that non-aiming cameras should follow you better if you turn this feature on. You can do that in the gameplay settings. If we then go over to the controls, we find an option to invert the vertical and horizontal camera controls. And we also see a touchpad tab here that I don't think was there before, but of course, correct me if I'm wrong. You can now disable the speaker names next to the subtitles if you don't want to see that. I like to see that, but totally like more options regarding this are always better. And I really like the increase to the subtitle size. You can now set it to large, and that makes reading the text from far away way easier. And you can also make the background transparent or turn it off like completely. And while it made it a little harder to read, I did like the fact that there was no background. Although I will likely go for the transparent option from now on. So the band notes in the patch notes that this is only the beginning of their push for more and better accessibility features in Days Gone, and that they are working on more and that they will be rolling them out in the coming months, also confirming a still pretty long life cycle for this game, and that's of course always great to see. Maybe New Game Plus. If I had to bet, I think they're working on it. But of course, don't take my word for it, it hasn't been confirmed yet. They also confirmed the release dates for the upcoming challenges, 6, 7 and 8, although it's not really like any surprise, because they're coming every Friday. So maybe with them noting it in the patch notes means that they are already part of this update. So that basically all the challenges are already like in the files, but that they just switch it on every Friday so that you don't have to download an update every time a new challenge is supposed to go live. With update 1.30, they also made a challenge specific fix for the 1%er ring that wasn't working in all challenges. I noticed that you now see a cross when you fail one of the sub-challenges in the new war challenge, so that you don't just see the points not being counted, but that you just see a big cross. So you know, okay, I failed that sub-challenge, I should probably restart the whole thing over again. Freaker should now have more fluid animations when interacting with ledges, something you can already see in this new war challenge, and the traps now appear on the mini-map, as you see right here. I'll put a link to the full patch notes so you can read them for yourself if you want in the description of this video. When we have more Days Gone updates or DLC coming to the game, I'll of course let you know here on the channel. Totally subscribe for everything on Days Gone, like this video to support the channel, and totally check out the tips and tricks video on how to get the gold medal for the new horde challenge. For now, I will speak to you next time, and goodbye.